Poštovani gledaoci, dobroveče. U ovoj današnjoj emisiji vidjet ćete kako su protekla dva humanitarna banketa održana ovde u Los Angelesu i San Marcosu. Lifeline, organizacija na čijem čelu se nalazi princeza Katarina Karađorđević, je u februaru mesecu na američkom kontinentu održala nekoliko banketa. Prvo su bila dva na Floridi i dva u Kaliforniji. 20. februara na Beverly Hillsu poznati srpski biznismen Milan Panić je pozvao dosta svojih prijatelja Srba i Amerikanaca i među gostima je bilo i uglednih srpskih naučnika, biznismena i ljudi iz sveta filma. Princ Aleksandar je dočekao sve goste, sa svakim strpljivo porazgovarao, slikao se i ponaosob objasnio tešku situaciju koja je sad trenutno u Srbiji, a posebno za decu.
We've been around to all the hospitals and it's quite something to see the aid that they need, and not only equipment but the training of doctors too.
When I look at all these people here tonight, I know all of them could have been someplace else, but they want to be here. They were drawn into this because they want to save lives, and this is what tonight is all about.
I'm honored to help out when I can. It's a great cause, you know. The media doesn't shed enough light on these problems, these humble situations that where people are struggling, and so we have to make an effort to get the attention and to get support, and so people's lives can improve.
Pre svega sam ponosna da sam pozvana i da evo kod nas, da je Srbija deo Srbije i srpskog duha i da se ovako jedna manifestacija održava baš ovde u Beverly Hillsu, u Los Angelesu.
I work on major issues like a peace in Balkans, as you know. I help children, even in Kosovo, we vaccinated all children in Kosovo. At my cost.
So it's a good night. It's a good night for helping children and for building friends.
I want also, you know, not just to be a speaker and spread a message of hope, but we really need to put love in action. So that's what tonight's all about, putting love in action.
Beautiful to see so many familiar faces, Serbian and Americans together. And I have to say that I have been chairing events for almost three decades, and this was a very special event for me, and I feel privileged being here. First of all, one of my great heroes, my mentor, really, an extraordinary man, a visionary, a true humanitarian, my uncle, Mr. Milan Panić, or shall I say His Excellency, Mr. Milan Panić. He's been honored tonight. This is the first event in almost three decades that sold out in 10 days. And that is thank you to Milan and all his friends that love him so much. Milan, you're such a loved man.
It is my privilege and honor to be here in your midst. I do not want to try my Serbian too much because I'm learning Spanish. My wife is half Japanese, half Mexican, Japsican. And when I try to speak Serbian, my brain starts fighting to speak Spanish at the same time. But I do remember when I was a child, my grandparents on both sides, my dad's dad especially, said, Deda, kako si? Granddad, how are you? And he said, biće bolje kad idemo gore. It'll be better when we get up there. The ultimate peace is within our soul. The ultimate peace is knowing our purpose here on earth is not just to experience, but to really make a difference. Mr. Panic, thank you for what you've done in your life, and I really am honored to have the friends of the royal family, Prince Alexander and Princess Catherine. When you and I were in the palace and we talked behind closed doors for a half an hour, and I want you to know that I've never met a couple who is so genuine, passionate, hands-on to really make a difference for the kids and the women and all of the suffering in Serbia. I would like it if we could all stand up to our feet and honor the royal family. I'm just touched to be here in your midst. And this all tonight is all about making a difference. It's about being the light and love and hands of change that this world needs. The Bible says that there will always be poor people. The Bible says there's always going to be a need. But the Bible always says as well that he's roaming around the world and saying, whom shall I send to alleviate the suffering of the world? And each and every one of us have a job, have a mission. And your mission may not look exactly like mine, and mine may not look like yours. But it starts and ends with love. It's the understanding that there is not one human being that is more valuable than another, and at the same time, not one human being that is less valuable than another. And I'm very thankful that we live in a day of age where we can together unite as one voice. I really believe that we are embarking on a change in the world. There are a lot of bad things happening, but at the same time, the people who strive for good, I believe we'll see good. I believe that this next generation will actually end world hunger. I really do believe that. I'm waiting for the day where 400 million people give a dollar a day to end world hunger. I've seen babies die because they had no incubator. I've seen babies being burnt on their skin because there's no incubators and they use the lamps in Dominican Republic. I've been in front of sex slaves who were kidnapped at 10 years old, sold by their parents for $700. And I've met the parents who were sorry for many things that they did to their children that they realized was wrong. We live in a world of a lot of pain. But today, it's all about hope. You and I, we cannot change the world tonight. The change starts with you and me, for real. It starts with us not just saying that we love people in the world. But I'll tell you right now, I have been 3 million miles around the world, which equates to about 100 times around the world. And I've never been so moved with compassion when I was in Serbia. I learned Serbian when I was 6 because my grandparents taught me and I picked it up. And I went to Serbia to an orphanage in Bela Crkva. And I was with 40 children there. And they were speaking to me in Serbian. I was trying to hold back my tears. Because ovo je naša deca. These are our children. You know, we're very thankful that we can say that me and my wife, we're happy. We love our family. Second child on the way. Thank God for our family. Thank God for our bloodline. Thank God for the people around us. You would do anything for your kid. Now a father, I can say that. What are we going to do for our kids in Serbia? These are our children. Be the voice for the people that have no voice. And let's bring resources that literally save lives. I believe one day in heaven, we will all meet people that maybe we've never met before, and they'll come up, and there'll be a long line of people who'll come up to you and say thank you for helping on the 20th of February, the HRH Foundation here. The royal family and everyone here, we're all doing the same thing, loving and making a difference as much as we can tonight. As a young Serbian, Australian, American, now living in LA, Serbia will always be a home for me that will be irreplaceable. And I just want you to hear from me that as my organization is growing, that we will continue to be in relationship with all of you and really together, not just tonight, but for the long term. You have my commitment. We really want to make a difference. And we love you all. So keep Serbia in prayer. Keep your family in prayer. Prayer is powerful. Love is powerful. But only when you're put into action. Thank you so much.
Praise the Lord, heaven, noble bride of Christ, the godly Catherine, the guardian of Sinai and its defense, who is also our support and comfort and help.
We're very honored to have you here, and I want to present you with this. This is an icon of our patroness, St. Catherine. And it's for you. Let's see if we can get it.
This is lovely.
Great.
This is very, very good. And you have, you're Catherine with a K?
We have Catherine with
like
a K.
Like I have mine.
Us with a K.
Where St. Catherine's Monastery is with a C.
With a C.
Very much. It is an honor and pleasure to be here today and to honor our the Royal Highnesses, Prince Alexander, and also Princess Catherine, and welcome them to the city of San Marcos. We appreciate you being here today. We also have the keys to the city of San Marcos to give to their Royal Highnesses. We want to say thank you and welcome. Here are the keys.
Reverend Fathers, Honorable Mayor and Mrs. Desmond, thank you very much for coming. Dear friends, it's a great pleasure to be back here in San Marcos. And first of all, I'd like to thank the Mayor of San Marcos, on behalf of my wife and myself, for honoring us very much. Thank you for your words. Thank you for the citation and the keys. When do they open?
Я сам буду свечи да будем опять от вас. Наша деца је дивно, наша будућност. И ви сте дивно људи да јесте се овде да помогате наша земљу. Я желим да кажем нешто за децу. Знате, деца, далеко бојате ингласки? И српски. Српски. Далеко бојате српски? You speak Serbian, some of you? I say it in English. I would like to say something for you. We have little children that come to the palace and they say, Princess, Princess, where is your crown? I say, my crown is in my heart, because without love, we can do nothing. Fathers, Mr. Mayor, dear friends, I'm very touched to be here tonight, to be with you, to be able to tell our story about our life in Serbia, about the privilege that we have to help the people in our country, to give them hope, to show them that they haven't been forgotten. And all of you here tonight, you're here because you care. I'm very lucky that I've had people in my life that I was able to help. People who I was able to see a smile. People that were crying, but after talking to them, after being with them, they were finally smiling. I wiped a lot of tears in our homeland, and I'm determined to make sure that everybody's happy. I was very lucky to have parents who taught me the joy of giving. When I was young, my mother told me happiness is when you give of yourself. And I prayed for an opportunity, and God blessed me with Alexander and a great country, Serbia. To Daniela and Yurko Bosniak, this lovely couple from New Jersey, who have set up all these charities. They had two in Florida just now that we went with my husband, St. Petersburg and Miami, and they had this one here tonight. I'm so grateful for their effort. I appreciate them very, very much.
Kako sam se osjećala? To se najbolje vidjelo na mom licu. Princeza Katarina je zaista Bogom dano biće za nas. Koliko se ona trudi i koliko pokušava da pomogne našu zemlju je dirljivo, zaista dirljivo. I ja pokušavam na način koliko ja mogu, na malo, koliko se to može ovdje, da prikupim da se pomogne našoj zemlji. Biti daleko od svoje zemlje je teško. Koliko god smo mi na neki način uspjeli da nešto uradimo, da naše živote stavimo ponovo na pravi kolosijek, teško je to. I svaki ovaj trenutak nas podsjeti koliko nam mnogo nedostaje naša zemlja, naša porodica, naša familija, sve mi nedostaje.
Well, it's been an honor, actually, to meet Princess Catherine and Prince Alexander. I mean, it's phenomenal to hear their story, what they actually do, and what they're using the money for back in Serbia. To me, it was, you know, almost brought me to tears to listen to her speech. And I think she should have done her speech before the auction, and that would have brought a lot more money. But it was very passionate, and I can tell that they're both great people, and they like to do great things for Serbia, and they're bringing that to America. And I think their realization of they're having us understand the needs of Serbia is an eye opener for us, and hopefully they get a lot of help.
Jako nas je dirnula govor naše princeze i vidjeli smo koliko je ona iskrena u celoj toj akciji i bilo je prirodno da odreagovao sam kao patriota i kao neko ko želi da pomogne. Ja sam pomagao i ranije našem narodu, ali ovo je sad prvi put da je organizovano preko neke organizacije pomaže.
Ideš na večeru u Beli dvor, da li imaš neke konkretna pitanja i ono što bi volio da razgovaraš?
To će biti sami, to će biti jedna jako onako uzbudljiva večera za nas, sa naše strane, ali imat ćemo puno toga da pričamo, jer oni su ljudi koji su daju život za druge ljude i pomažu drugim ljudima i to nama jako odgovara, meni i moje suprze.
Da se struški mamo, struški sobe.
Super je bilo, samo sam izgubio malo pare večeras, 2500 na jednu večeru. Ali to je za dobar prilog, za decu, za Srbiju.
Znači, kako misliš da provedeš tu večer sa princezom i sa princem?
Pa u stvari sam teo da dati ocu i majku, da oni idu.
Lepo.
To sam za njih kupio.
To je baš lep gest od tebe.
Uspešno. Ja mislim da su princ i princeza mnogo zadovoljni, da je sve završilo kako treba, da se ipak doniralo dosta love što se tiče te fondacije njezne Lifeline.
Ja sam se primila da budem organizator ovoga, pošto sam poznata sa Lifeline. Moj muž i ja smo već koliko godina pomagali. I tako da kažem, mislim, ovo mi je bilo drago da učinim. A što mi je još više bilo drago, kad sam pozvala narod da mi pomognu i kazala sam o čemu se radi. I naravno, narod je hteo da zna šta, zašto i kako. I meni, ja sam im naravno objasnila, a meni je mnogo drago što je princeza večeras objasnila i kazala. I ona stvarno sama priča i radi sa osjećanjem. I to je jedna velika stvar da narod koji ne zna i nije upoznat šta ona radi i kako rade i princ naravno. Tako da kažem, mislim, ovo mi je mnogo drago da je narod imao šansu da i čuje lično. Prvo sam pohvalila princa da mnogo bolje govori srpski sada nego pre koliko godina kad sam ga prvi put videla. I on kaže, i njemu je naravno drago, pošto ovdje dosta naroda, i to ih je interesovalo, znate kako, sve narod interesuje, naročito nešto što oni nisu upoznati. Ali što se tiče večeras, kao što kažem, mislim da je bilo uspešno, uvek ima mesta da se nešto popravi, ali ipak, kad pričate oko skoro 400 naroda, nije lako, mislim, sve uraditi kako bi možda trebalo. Mi moramo da pazimo na protokol, mi treba da znamo na šta mi možemo da učinimo. E sad, drugo, šta bi mi hteli. Tako da kažem, mislim, sve u svemu da je bilo, ako mogu da kažem, do nekada da je bilo uspešno.
Su mnogo dirljivi za mene, naravno, zato što imam dete sa specijalnim potrebama koje raste, koje je rođeno u ovoj zemlji i želela bi samo da deo ovog sistema koji imamo ovde i ove privilegije koje ova naša deca imaju da prenesemo za tu decu tamo u Srbiji.
Bilo je divno, ja sam bio ovde 75, to je pre mnogo godina, ja sam bio mlad čovek. Ja sam bio vrlo srećan da sam vratio sa mojom suprugom i ovom divnom dobrotvornim večera koji mi smo imali. I ja sam vrlo ponos moja supruga koji je držio govor i da ljudi zna šta je situacija u našoj zemlji. Imamo mnogo teškoće, ali pomoć koju dobimo ovde kao ovaj primer, to je vrlo dobro. Moja supruga, mi smo bili u mnogo bolnici, mnogo poseta i vidimo svaki put šta treba i treba mnogo, mnogo pomoć, nove opreme, tako dalje.
Ona je rekla da je važno da i mi pomognemo njoj, da mi radimo isto to za dobrobit svih nas. Da. To je najvažnija poruka i to je nešto što sam video da ljudi plaču kada je ona govorila.
Da, moja supruga kad govori, govori od srca. Kad drži govor, to je od srca. E to je divno. Ja sam također malo uzbuđen kad slušam moja supruga. Da, ona je videla mnogo teškoće i ja mislim da ljudi osjeća se kao moji supruga. Da.
Vi definitivno dajete tu pozitivnu energiju, narod je uz vas, mi jedva čekamo ponovo da se vidimo, zato što lepo se zabavljamo i volimo od srca da damo.
Veliko hvala. I moji supruga, volimo mnogo naš narod. I naš narod je uvek u nas sa srcem.
Hoćemo u kolo sada.
Hvala.